Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to do a new topic, that is alkyl groups. And what are alkyl groups and what are the classification of it? Let us learn about that. So now, before understanding what are the classification of alkyl group, it is very necessary for us to understand that is what is actually alkyl group. So an alkyl group is a free radical obtained by homolytic fission of carbon hydrogen bond in alkane. So this is what I want to explain you. Suppose if we have taken a alkane like ethane, or suppose the first alkane, that is methane. So suppose if this is the structure of methane that we know. And now what we have got to know about alkyl group is, alkyl group is nothing but a radical in which carbon and hydrogen bond breaks, and that radical will only form when the fission or when the breaking of the bond between the carbon and hydrogen is basically a homolytic fission. So now, therefore, if this carbon and this hydrogen breaks homolytically, so that means that one electron will stay with the carbon and one electron will stay with the hydrogen. Suppose if they break in this manner, so now what will happen? We could see that the carbon now has one electron of its own, and the hydrogen also has its electron, let me name it at X. So now, in this case, this is the alkane group, or this is the alkane that we know and basically known as methane. But as we could see here, because there is only one hydrogen atom less in the whole alkane, so now this will be called as alkyl. So now this is alkyl, and mainly it has been derived from the methane, so therefore the name of this would be methyl. So therefore this is a methyl radical. So you could also call it as radical, because this is a radicals are basically the neutral species in which we could see that the valencies are not being fulfilled. So here also the valency of the carbon is 4, but the three valency, among the four valency, the three valencies are being filled because of the hydrogen that are being attached to it, while one is not being fulfilled, and we could see that one electron is remain as it is. And moreover, we could see that this carbon is not a positive charged species, not a negative charged species, because this is this doesn't contains one electron less so as to become a carbocation, or it doesn't contains an extra electron so as to become a carboanion. So therefore this is basically a neutral species known as radical. And moreover, since we are talking about alkanes and we have derived this from an alkane, so therefore this would be called as alkyne. And one thing to notice, that this is an alkane, and alkane has the general formula, that is CnH2n+2. But in this case, as we could see, that because of one hydrogen is less, so therefore the general formula of this would be CnH2n+1. So instead of 2, there will be 1, because one hydrogen is less. So therefore this is the general formula of the alkyl groups. So let us check whether it is validate or not. So for that, I will take another example. Suppose if we have CH3CH3, that is known as basically ethane. So therefore this is ethane with us, and if I want to make it into an alkyl group, or if I want to convert into ethyl, so how can I do? One thing that we have to do is we have to just eliminate one hydrogen from the overall alkane, so then only we could derive an alkyl group from an alkane. So now this will be turned into CH3CH2. This bond doesn't represents that it has an extra electron, because the carbon valency is basically it has 4 valency when we are talking about carbon. But as we could see here, this is not a bond, this is just an extension that the alkyl group can be formed, or this could attach to with any other species or any other atom. So that's the reason this is an extension. So what would be the general formula in this case? Yes, as we know that the general formula, in because this is ethane and ethane is the one which would obey the formula, that is CnH2n+2. But if we observe here, so the total number of carbon, if you could see, is basically 2, and the total number of hydrogen in here basically is 5. So we could write this with a general formula, that is CnH2n+1. We could write in this manner also. So therefore, this is the one which have n is equals to 2. So this is the general formula of the alkyne. So now we are know very well known about what is an alkyl group, and along with that we have also done that what would be the general formula of the alkyl group or alkyl radical. So now when we are talking about the classification, so even the classification are being divided into three types, just same as we have did in our previous lecture for alkane. So now in this case we are going to learn about the classification of alkyl group. So now we are going to talk about the classification of alkyl group, and alkyl groups are being divided into three types, that is primary alkyl group, secondary alkyl group, and tertiary alkyl group. So the thing that we have drawn earlier, so in this case is this. So this is basically an ethyl group. This could be called as ethyl radical if there would have been no extension, as we could see that CH3, CH2, CH2, and if there would be a dot present, then that would have been called as ethyl radical. But in this case, since we are talking about ethyl or an alkyl group, so therefore this extension, which means that this is the one that could be joined with any other atom or any other species, so as to complete the bond between them. So now we are talking about the alkyl group, and alkyl groups are basically of three types, that is primary, secondary, and tertiary. So what is actually primary, secondary, and tertiary group? So let us discuss about this individually. So talking about the first one, that is what is primary alkyl group. So it means that in alkyl group, the valency of the primary carbon atom is available. The valency of the primary carbon atom, and we know in our that we have did this lecture earlier also about primary carbon atom, secondary carbon atom, tertiary, and quaternary. So in this case, we have also got to know that the primary carbon is available in this case. So as to make also as to understand that is what is primary alkyl group. So for that, suppose if we have an example like this one, this is what we have did earlier also. So in this group that we have, or in this alkyl group that we have, we can observe that this is the primary carbon atom. Why? Because this is the carbon atom which has been attached directly to a one carbon atom only. So that's the reason this would be the primary carbon atom. And while talking about the group, the whole group would be called to be a primary alkyl group. So this is basically known as a primary alkyl group. And what would be the name of this thing? Then we could also give a common name, as well as we could also give the IUPAC name to this group that we have. So this group can be named as ethyl group. That would be common name, as well as that could be the IUPAC name. So this is the primary alkyl group. So now let us talk about the another group that we are going to discuss. And that is secondary alkyl group. So what is actually secondary alkyl group? In this alkyl group, the valency of a secondary carbon atom is available, and we know that what is secondary carbon atom. Secondary carbon atom is a when it comes to talking about alkane. So secondary carbon atom is a carbon atom which has been attached to two other carbon atoms in a same molecule. So therefore, there would be a secondary carbon atom that would be present to show that what is a secondary alkyl group. So for that, we have an example that would be easy to understand. So suppose if we have CH3, CH, CH2, CH3. So this is a group where we could see this valency, or this carbon atom valency, has been showcased here. And moreover, we could see that this carbon atom is been attached to two different carbon atoms in the same molecule itself. So making this molecule to be called as secondary carbon atom. So now this is the secondary carbon atom which has been attached to two different carbon atoms. So therefore this would be called as a secondary alkyl group, as we could see that this is the valency that has been showcased, and this valency has not been fulfilled. So now this would be called as secondary alkyl group. But what would be the common name of this thing? The common name of this thing would be, we could name it as the total number of carbon here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 number of carbon atoms. So therefore the 4 carbon atoms are being called to be butyl or butane when it comes to an alkane. So because this is a alkyl group, so the name would end with butyl. And moreover, we could see that it is not the branching, or we could see that the valency has been not shown case on the primary carbon atom, as well as it is shown, and moreover it is shown on the secondary carbon atom. So that is the reason the name of this would be, when it comes to common name, it would be secondary butyl radical or secondary butyl group. So what would be the IUPAC name of this thing? So IUPAC name of this thing would be, so there are specific criteria to give the number. As we could see that this is a group where we could see the valency, or this is the secondary carbon atom, so the numbering will start from the secondary carbon itself in this case when it comes to IUPAC naming. So this is the carbon where we could see that the group or the valency is being showcased and which is not being fulfilled. So therefore we'll name this carbon to be 1, this carbon to be 2, and this carbon to be third carbon atom. So in this case we could see that this is a carbon atom which has been attached to the first carbon atom when it comes to the IUPAC naming. So therefore, because CH3 has been attached to the first carbon atom, where the valency is now been available, where we could see, so therefore the name of this would be 1-methyl. The total number of carbon rather than this is 3, so the name of this would be propyl. So 1-methyl propyl is the IUPAC name of this example, basically for secondary alkyl group. So this were the two classification that we have mentioned. So the one classification has been remaining, and that is tertiary alkyl group. So let us talk about that also. So now we are talking about a tertiary alkyl group, and in this alkyl group what happens is the valence of the tertiary carbon atom has been available. So it is very easy to understand. Suppose if I have an example, like if I have chosen this one. Suppose this is the valency that I could observe, and this carbon is basically known as tertiary carbon atom when it comes to an alkane. We have did a lecture on this also. So this carbon atom, because it has been attached to three different carbon atoms in the same molecule, so therefore this carbon is said to be tertiary carbon atom. So therefore this is an example where we could see that this carbon, which is basically known as the tertiary carbon atom, has a valency available. So now therefore the overall alkyl group would be called to be, more specifically, tertiary alkyl group. So this is tertiary alkyl group that we could see. And what would be the common name of this thing? So the common name of this thing would be, as the total number of carbon here, as you could see, is basically 5. So 5 carbon atom, it end with pentyl. And moreover, we could see that we are talking about a tertiary carbon atom. So therefore the name of this would be tertiary pentyl. So easy. So let us discuss about what would be the IUPAC name. So therefore, the IUPAC name would be easy to detect, as we did earlier also, because the numbering will start from the carbon atom where the valency is being showcased, or where we could see that the carbon's valency is being available. So in this case, we could see that this is the carbon where the valency is being available. So I will name this carbon to be 1, this carbon to be 2, and this carbon to be 3. So in this case, what I observe is, I observe that there are 2 methyl groups that have been attached to the first carbon atom when it comes to the numbering. So therefore the name of this would be 1, 1, and methyl is repeating 2 times, so the 2 methyl groups have been present on the first carbon atom when it comes to the IUPAC naming. So therefore this would be 1, 1 dimethyl, and total number of carbon in a straight chain, or what we have chosen in that manner, is 3. So 3 means basically propane, but this is an alkyl group, so the name of this would be propyl. 1,1 dimethyl propyl. So this is the thing that we have got to know in tertiary alkyl groups, and yes, we have differentiated. It was very similar to that of the alkane that we have studied, but this is alkyl. So even this is very much important to understand, because in future also we are going to learn about the IUPAC name of the alkanes, and in that case what will happen is there will be this kind of group that will be attached in a straight chain. So therefore it is very necessary for us to understand that what is the common name, or what do we pronounce when it comes to the common name, and how do we write the IUPAC name if we have this kind of structure that we have studied through primary alkyl group, secondary alkyl group, and tertiary alkyl group. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, as well as we have got to know that what is the electronic configuration of this group. So share this video with your friends, and yes, I hope you have liked this video. So don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.